Look, it continues to be a bleak picture for the country's municipalities. We're looking at 32 billion rand lost in the 2018-2019 period. So virtually, we're looking at about 80% of these municipalities in a bad financial state, 34 of which could face collapse. Lack of oversight amongst the cited reasons. This is not new. Why is there a continued lack of municipal officials not being held accountable or lack of consequence management?
Thank you very much, Griselda. And once again, good evening to the viewers. What is very apparent and clear from the audit outcomes that we are releasing today is that the transgressions of yesteryears that had been reported even before my time are unlikely to change if there is no visible action taken to address those particular historical findings. Mm-hmm. And you find that people then find a fertile environment in that municipality to carry out transactions that might be feathering somebody's nest rather than fully responding to the needs of that particular community. So it is the absence of consequence in essence, Griselda. And you look at it from many angles. One, if those people are struggling to do this work themselves, it's very easy for them to go and seek an external service provider to come and assist them at additional cost to the municipality as well. So you can imagine now you've got an unsustainable double cost in the institution, which is catering for an external service provider, but there are also warm bodies in that finance department. Again, that situation is allowed to continue because the council and those that are charged with oversight do not activate their responsibilities.
What one could perhaps also argue, Auditor-General, is that you said a bit earlier on that there are a couple of cases of known officials who've transgressed a number of times in some of these municipalities in the past. You have these investigations that start, but they never see conclusion. How do you then enforce accountability in these instances?
That is why when we look at all these audit outcomes, we tend to pay our closer attention to the role that must be played by leadership. Because if leadership does not act on those situations, other people are not empowered to deal with that situation. Hence, we think that if the leadership has in councils, because they are accountable to their respective communities for all activities taking place in these municipalities, and we think that for as long as leadership does not get pushed to act on transgressions, the more they are going to allow that environment to fester and become a place where you can't even find a contract to substantiate a massive transaction.
If you look, for example, AG, at the amount of money that is spent on consultants by these municipalities, that has also gone up, I think you said, by over a billion rand. That's another concern. Why is it also allowed that when there are officials hired within these municipalities to do this kind of work, it is outsourced to somebody else to do the books?
There was a time in many of these municipalities, I'm sure, it's not too long ago, where for various reasons there were many people that were in employment and were continuing to be employed in various positions. And some of those positions are not necessarily the kind of positions that are going to deliver services. It could be a strategic liaison officer type of job or a combination of those things. Now, those type of things, they clog up the system because they tend to stand in the way of those that have to do the real work. And you soon realize that there was no real technical skill that you are going to get from this particular individual, even though they are already employed. Now you go out and seek the services of an external service provider, educational cost. And I think it is also the absence of that proper resource planning that does not take place between different units of the municipality together with its human resource capacity. If it was given to achieve those things. And I think you've got a broken system at a fundamental level, Christelda, which cannot only be helped by the financial instrument being put right. The financial instrument is normally a window into deeper and deeper malaise that has first started into an institution. And I think it must be looked at from the leadership angle to say what is the role of leadership to fix that.
AG, nothing is going to change. I think the crux of your report today focused on exactly what we've been talking about, a complete lack of accountability. So to enforce this, one of the measures being suggested to National Treasury, I think it was Salga that brought it up in that press briefing you had, is that they must look at into implementing, I think it's Section 216 of the Constitution, which empowers them to say that until a municipality begins to deal with corrective measures, their equitable share must be withheld. That raises a bit of concern, because what effect would this then have on the ability of the municipality to carry out services to communities?
So I think you are right that there are many ways to effect consequences. And if you look at that one as one of the options, it will come with its own difficulties, because it will start having a real impact on many other people that may claim they do not have control over the judicious management of the finances of this institution. So it would be something when they implement it that they need to do with great care. But I think it is a pressure in the right direction, because what it says is that you cannot be freely allowed to access the resources that are collected through the debt system. But when it comes to accounting for them, you suddenly have a different story about it. So it's about restoring that level of accountability where it belongs, to say that whatever it is that is dispersed in your municipality, you shall hold accountability for it through your instruments as well as through your councils. And that's the only way. Otherwise, we will be chasing our tails trying to figure out what happened to the assets of a particular municipality if we did not take due care up front.
Auditor General, I'm afraid that's all we have time for. Thank you very much indeed for joining us this evening and waiting those extra few minutes. Auditor General Kimi Makwetu joining us, of course, after releasing his report earlier on today. A bleak picture for municipalities. Once again, 32 billion rand lost to fraud and corruption in a number of municipalities across the country. Let's take a short break here on The Full View. We'll have much more when we get back.